हेलो, माय नेम इज़ सुरेंद्र सिंह एंड दिस इज़ माय बीटीपी प्रेजेंटेशन। माय टॉपिक इज़ कॉल डिटेल एनालिसिस सॉफ्टवेयर एंड माय गाइड इज़ शर्मिष्ठा मैम। सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज़ व्हाट इज़ अ सीडीआर एनालिसिस सॉफ्टवेयर। अ सीडीआर एनालिसिस सॉफ्टवेयर इज़ यूज्ड बाय पुलिस टू एनालाइज कॉल डिटेल्स ऑफ ए पर्सन, ए सिम और अ टावर। एंड टू शो द स्कोप ऑफ दिस सॉफ्टवेयर, पर डिस्ट्रिक्ट देर आर 2,000 to 3,000 CDR एनालिसिस आर डन पर मंथ। सो हाउ समवन गेट ए CDR? सो फर्स्ट लेट्स से समबडी फाइल ए पुलिस रिपोर्ट विच नीड्स CDR एनालिसिस। सो इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर राइट्स एन एप्लीकेशन टू SP ऑफिस, दे फॉरवर्ड इट टू टेलीकॉम सर्विस प्रोवाइडर लाइक Airtel एंड Jio, एंड देन दे सेंड बैक it to SP office, and then SP office send back it to investigating officer. So what are some general uses of CDR analysis? So first is finding a lost phone and checking the presence of a victim and criminal at the crime scene, place visited by criminal before and after crime, checking if the criminal stayed with someone. It saves time and help in fair investigation, manhunt, finding criminal contacts and verifying false accusation are some other general uses. So what are the information we can get from CDR? So first is when and where the criminal sleeps. Second, whom he calls before sleeps, frequent calls, whom he calls first in the morning, once he only talk to 1 or 2 days, means new client, where he goes regularly. There are a lot of information we can get from CDR. So this is one of the example of CDR's input file. This is sent by SP office to the investigation officer. This is something which looks like, so you can see there are different informations here. So first is caller, who is calling. Then in the fourth we can see it's a whom he is calling. Then there's date, time, duration. Then the first cell ID is the tower where he is in. Last cell ID is the tower when he cut the phone. Then is it a call type like SMS or call, and then IMEI number, which is a phone model number, and IMSI number, which is a SIM card number. It's different from phone number. It's the number written on the SIM and it's physically written on the SIM. Type of call, it's prepaid or postpaid. SMS center is if there's a SMS coming from some company, then it will be written as SMS center. Then roaming, if it's in roaming, and then roaming circle, which is like VFRG, is Vodafone Rajasthan. So now we have to analyze this raw data in some other form. So there are a few existing software like Purple, C5, ShieldX, CBFS and CDR E&I. So all of these have different things in them, like some is online, offline, their learnability and how they work. So the best one of them is Purple, because it's fun. It's updated more frequently because it's online, it works online, and it's easy to learn, and it's Windows only. So this is how Purple looks like. So there are few problems with it. So if as we can see, so let's say number one, you have to select where some information which are not necessary to select, because these things are written inside the CDR file. Then second thing, which is a lot of links which are not required by user that frequently, that they are always there. Then third one is a side panel which is only required once when he started the software, which is always there again. Then a fourth one is the branding, which is taking more than required space, which gives less space for showing the data. Then fifth one are the tabs, which are used more frequently, but there are only limited space to show them. There are only 5 we can see at a time, but there are like 15 or 14 of them in the column. So next is, there are more. Seventh is the data representation is not accurate. So as we can see, this how many call he made on different days is shown by a pie chart, whether there it's not accurate, and we can provide better way of representing this data, like bar graph. And there are very less of things which are represented with this. Last one is they summary and all, they don't use any symbol or color or anything. They just simply show like in tabular form, which can we see, which is similar to the raw data form. Next one, another software is CDR A&I, which is also here. It has similar problems. As we can see, it has no graphics and a lot of textual information. So my design brief was to design a cross-platform compatible, easy to use CDR analysis software with simplified navigation, including features like cross-platform report sharing, using colors and symbols to represent data, spam filtering, CDR requesting application, print analysis report, sorting and filtering, suggesting phone model by using EMIs, ad-based-free services. So what is the demography of the user? So mostly police officers who are using this CDR software are between age of 25 and 45. They have education of bachelor's degree mostly. Computer skills are they can use MS Office and Facebook in general. They cannot find complex option in this software. Like my experience is I asked few officers to try using watermark and they did not know what is watermark and why they need to use it and where is the option, and they don't know complex options in Facebook also. So officers using CDR are also unsupervised. There is no one to teach them how to use these softwares. So first thing I wanted to differentiate was, should we make a web-based software or an offline software? So there are few comparison things like fast web-based have fast analysis, easy to send update and fixes, easy to access over any device, network dependent, hacker may try to steal the data. But offline has more secured, it is not centralized, work without internet, loading speed is not network dependent, PC failure may cause data loss, slow analysis. So we come up with a different plan. We want to make a website that works and keep data offline. It will upload quickly, data will remain secure. We can use system to keep data, load algorithm and UI from web, and only send data that need more detail, like tower name from the tower ID. So this was one of my initial card shooting for how the user flow will, how the tabs and all will work. So we made this. So one will be add CDR, means the raw file, and there are four main options: call, location, map and pattern. So they have different sub options. Then there is a side panel which have account settings, search, help and printing and bookmark. So this is how the initial screen looks like. You can now add the file here, then you it's loading, and then it's start with the call panel. You can see the first is showing phone numbers, then it's the call type, and then there's the duration. I written M and S small so that they can be differentiated easily. Then I used AM and PM with different colors to make it easy to distinguish, and date and location. Location at the end of the location, there are colors which shows what is the location. Every location is associated a color in the beginning, and these colors are arranged in a way that one is more frequent than other. So always yellow will be the most frequent, and orange will be the second, and then red will be third, and so on. Next, there is a side panel. You can click on it and it's open up. It shows more detail about a particular phone number. So let's say the first phone number, if you selected, it's showing the history of that one phone number. Then there is a location tab. It shows all the location where user went. It have so I use morning and evening instead of exact time to make it easy to read it. When you hover on these, the exact time will be written instead of morning or evening. And then there are how many calls and duration. Then again, you have the side panel which shows you more detail about that one particular, how many the calls of that one particular location. So this is a map view. So it shows there's at the bottom there is a timeline, and you can see like let's say we selected the purple one, so it shows it came from orange and then it's going to yellow after this. And same again, it have the side panel to show calls of that particular location selected. Then there's the important tab of patterns. So this is the first tab inside patterns tab, which is call analysis. So it shows longest calls, frequent calls, most longest location and most frequent locations. Then at the bottom it's written mode of call time and average of call time. Mode is required because it shows more accurate information than average. So yeah, again you can filter this thing by date and time. Next tab is call versus time. This graph shows more information. As first thing, there are filters that you can filter out things. Then there's a time filter with what time of day to what time of day you want to filter these things. So if we can see, so red is the these are the location which are colored, and so this also shows the frequency when particular time he calls most in the day. So as in this we can see from 12 p.m. to 6 7 around he is not calling more, and then in his calling it can show what time particularly a person is more busy calling someone. Then also it shows if he went somewhere in, let's, you can see the green line at in this area. So this green line shows from what time he went to this green location and then when he came back from call. So yeah, that's it. Next graph is location versus time. It shows what location, where he was from what time to what time, on what date to what date, and it also shows his home location based on his sleepings, like the time he is inactivate, his phone is inactive, and he's at a particular location for longer time. So that is a home, like we come home and sleep. So generally we don't use phone after sleeping. So from that we can find it's a home. Is it a home? Then office is where he calls more frequent, or he's there in the daytime. And then there are other locations. And the next one is sleep pattern, sleep location, which shows the sleeping time of him. And in the you can see there these candles show the exact time from finding out the average of all the sleep times, and those small lines shows the inaccuracy, like he did not made a call, but we think he can only sleep for 8 hours, and for the rest of it we think like he may be sleeping, may not be sleeping. So it's the uncertainty line. So yeah, next will be consecutive calls. It shows how many consecutive calls. So it shows one call after another he always makes. So it help in finding a relation between phone numbers. And last one is a SIM and phone timeline. This shows the timeline of changing SIM and phone of a person. So if he changes SIM or phone, it comes here with date. So what next? There are we already done more than half of the development. And user interview, we could not take anything. We are still finishing development, and we'll try to do heuristic everything. I mean, I'm taking it as a startup in future. I'm trying to, this corona and everything stopped a lot of things. So yeah, we have to do a lot in this, and my team is still working on development. They done they made more progress than last time, more than mid semester, and will be finished. I think after finishing exam, everyone will be not going to job for few times. So I will be doing this thing for that time, and yeah, thank you everyone, thank you for watching.